Good morning. So, last couple of weeks we have been looking at moisture thermodynamics. We have been defining quantities one by one. We are solving problems of graded difficulty and graded complexity. So now we are in a position where you can get the lifting condensation level, you can find out the potential temperature, you can find out the dew point, you know what the wet bulb temperature is and so on. With all these definitions, we should be able to solve problems where some atmospheric processes are involved. There is an air parcel which is going up, then it is condensing, then it is coming down, it is coming from the left side of the mountain, there is a wind, it goes up to the mountain and then it reaches some height. It sheds moisture, it comes from the other side, it comes back through the other side of the mountain, it is descending, and what happens to the temperature, whether the temperature on the windward side and the leeward side of the mountains are one and the same. This really leads to various phenomena, and then meeting of the cold front and the warm front, which leads to, these are called frontal masses, which leads to several interesting atmospheric phenomena and so on. So we are not yet done with our definitions of thermodynamic quantities. So, we will have to look at two very important quantities in today's class. We look at the formal derivation of this, then we will see how to get these quantities on the SkewT Lon P chart. Then we will turn around and then solve one or two problems where we will start from first principles and calculate all the quantities up to what we discussed today. Then in the next class, in Tuesday's class, we will just take up an atmospheric phenomena, and from a knowledge of moisture thermodynamics and the expertise you have gained in using the SkewT Lon P chart, with minimum recourse to formulae and maximum use of the SkewT Lon P chart, can we solve problems involving atmospheric processes through the use of charts alone. Okay? And then after you use the charts and all that, you will get some values. For example, you can get so many grams per kilogram moisture, this dry bulb, wet bulb temperature and dew point and so on. Okay? So the quantities we are going to discuss today are the equivalent potential temperature. Equivalent potential temperature and wet bulb potential temperature. Okay, the next two important quantities are sir, we already saw potential temperature. Why are you saying equivalent potential temperature? Good question. But the answer is, the potential temperature looked at dry air. But now we have graduated. We have started looking at moist air. So if there is an adiabatic process involving moist air, then theta equal to constant will not do. There is some other line. Okay, that line you already know. Those curves already we saw yesterday. But now we will go through a formal derivation. So watch this carefully. Applying first law, the net heat added is equal to work done and this VDP, correct? Is this correct? How about this? Is also all right? Now use the ideal gas equation and replace P in the denominator. Replace rho in the denominator. Okay. quite all right, isn't it? I want to divide by T throughout. So keep this result, then the power of take ln both sides. Is this correct? It's quite all right. That constants of P naught into R by something, right? Minus R is correct, right? Minus R by C P ln P is correct because P is in the denominator. I want to multiply by C P throughout. For the sake of completeness, let me write taking ln both sides. Taking ln on both sides. Okay, so we are nowhere near equivalent potential temperature. But whatever we know, we first write. Knowledge always proceeds from the unknown to the known, right? So whatever we know about this air parcel, we keep on writing. We apply the first law, we apply this potential temperature, all this, and keep these milestones, and then we will look at the, and the last but one step, we will invoke the definition of equivalent potential temperature and pull out whatever we want, okay. Now, I will multiply throughout by Cp. This can be some other constant, don't bother about this. So far so good, there is nothing new we have discussed so far, which we have not seen in the earlier part of the course. But now, I want to introduce an arbitrary quantity and we want to see its variation. And then looking at the variation of the arbitrary quantity, which involves the latent heat of vaporization and the saturation mixing ratio, it lead to some intermediate steps. Then we will try to connect up to either equation 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, keep all these results, and then we will mix and match and we will do a khichdi and finally we will pull out the equivalent potential temperature. Is it okay? I want to look at the quantity. D of the latent heat of vaporization into the saturation mixing ratio. What does it give actually? Leave the D off. What is the numerator? Latent heat, right? Kilojoule per kg into kg per kg. So, for 1 kg of air, what is the latent heat? Denominator is specific heat, some energy content. It may not be, you will argue with me, see, Cp delta T, sir. But Cpt is the amount of heat stored or something like sensible heat. So, this ratio we want to look at. Now, since we are considering small ranges of temperature and the processes are not taking place over wide ranges of temperature, I want to pull out LV and Cp out of this. Can I do that? Now, please pull out the partial derivatives from this. Please expand this. I will start with, though it is not an equation, first term minus omega s by T square dt, correct? Second term d omega s by t. Now, I will have to do an order of magnitude analysis to find out whether both the terms are significant or one of the two terms is of leading order, that is one term is 9, other term is 1, or one term is 9.5, the other term is 0.5, so that we can remove one of the two terms so that we can proceed further with the analysis, because it may lead to some simplification. Therefore, I want to look at this quantity. So, if omega s is about 15 grams per kilogram and d omega s is 3 or 4 or kilograms per 4 or 5 grams per kilogram, this d omega s by omega s may be the order of half, one third and so on. But if it is only 5 Kelvin change and T is 300 Kelvin, please look at the magnitudes of Tt by T and d omega s and omega s and tell me whether dt by t is approximately equal to d omega s by omega s, dt by t is much, much greater than d omega s by omega s, or dt by dt is much smaller compared to d omega s by omega s. Dt by dt, much small, very good. I will also say if, then I will say generally it is applicable in the atmosphere. Okay, if dt by d omega, generally dt by ds, but here we will make a conditional statement, if dt by ds is less than this, then so you get LV by, what do you get? Which is more important? What do you get? LB by CP by T. All right, quite all right. Now, this is fine, equation number 11, let us put some color. Okay. Where are we heading? Are we going in an aimless direction? Where is the connection? Please let me know. What is sir doing? That question may be uppermost in your mind now. What am I trying to do? What is the result from the first law? dq by? What? dq by t equal to? Minus r, something is there. So, we have worked out L, V, C, P, all that. Now, we have to link up the two. So, tell me a way out. What will be dq if only latent heat change is involved? Then you are hitting the bullseye. Is the question clear? dq will be equal to minus Lv d omega s. When it is just about to change phase, dq will not be equal to Cp delta T because there is no sensible heat. Okay, so we are talking about saturation where some water is changing into water vapor or water vapor is changing into water. Therefore, dq will be equal to Lv d omega s. Then the connection is automatically established and this series of these steps which you have done can be put to good use. Okay, now is the connection clear now? Therefore, that minus is heat removed from the system, all that. I want to be consistent. Is that okay? Therefore, the other equation is also there, no? D theta by theta, okay. Yeah. So, you had the equation. I forgot the numbers. You had an equation dq by t is equal to Cp dt minus r to dp by dp, then d theta by d. Compare these two equations and are you getting this? Are you getting this? I made a mistake. Where is the Cp? Very good. Correct. Very good. How? Please help me from equations. Which are the two equations? Tell me the number. 5 and 8. Is it correct? Is it going to be shown to others? Is it correct? Sai Sneha. 5 and 8. Okay. So, I am going to write here. So, by comparing equations 5 and 8, we got that Cp d theta by theta equal to dq by t. Watch what I am going to do now. Dq I know is Lv dWs. Therefore, this will be minus Lv d omega s by t. But Lv d omega s by t and d of that is nothing but d of Lv omega s by t is this. Then it becomes a perfect differential. D theta by d theta and d of this thing I integrate. Then I'll look at what happens when omega s by t goes to 0. When omega s goes to 0, when all the water vapor, all the moisture is removed, it reaches a temperature that is theta E, equivalent potential temperature. Is that okay? Let us complete the derivation. So, everybody is wearing a puzzled look. Yeah, is it too much or no? You have to learn this. What is it? By T, yeah? So this is nothing but minus D of Will you agree with me? Okay. 14. Please integrate. So, what do you get? I think we get minus at low temperatures, when omega s by T goes to 0, that the air parcel is completely removed of all its moisture, this theta will approach an equivalent, will approach a temperature called theta E, which is the equivalent potential temperature. Okay. So, let us complete the derivation. So, we can make it 16. Plus fine. So theta E is called the equivalent potential temperature. Is it okay? Let us take the formal derivation, formal definition for this. So, hang on. So, theta E is the equivalent potential temperature, is the potential temperature of an air parcel when all the vapor, all the water vapor has condensed. So, that is its saturation mixing ratio is 0. There is no water vapor available, everything is condensed. I come again, theta E is the potential, I will formally state it, you first understand. Theta is the potential temperature of the air parcel, is what happens to it, what happens to the temperature, and all the water vapor is condensed, so that its saturation mixing ratio is 0. Okay, and theta E equivalent potential temperature is defined. As the temperature reached by the air parcel, theta E, the equivalent potential temperature, is the temperature reached by a parcel of air when all the water vapor has condensed. So that its omega S equal to 0. Okay? How to get the theta E? How to get the theta E? Tell me from the QT Lonnpy chart. I will tell you, just listen to this carefully. The equivalent potential temperature theta E of an air parcel may be found by lifting the air parcel adiabatically until all the water vapor has condensed. It has released its latent heat and the condensed water vapor has fallen out. It is having no moisture now, but it is at some height, it is not at its original height. From that height, it is compressed in a dry adiabatic fashion all the way up to its initial temperature, all the way up to its up to a pressure of, let us say, usually 1000 hPa. Okay? And the point where it intersects the 1000 hPa isobar, the dry adiabat is called the equivalent potential temperature. Okay? So, if an air parcel is lifted, first it will go dry adiabatically. It will go dry adiabatically up to what level? Lifting condensation level. Then suppose we say it is lifted further, then it will point, it will go to a, it will go through a saturated adiabat. At that point, I declare that this fellow has left out all its water. Then you have to rework the point for that pressure for a new omega s, which is close to 0, and then from there all the way dry adiabatically compress it back to 1000 hPa. This is quite different from the theta or the potential temperature, where the question of omega s does not arise. Are you getting the point? So, what are the definition of the potential temperature theta? The potential temperature theta was conserved during dry adiabatic transformations. Please note down, please take down, the equivalent potential temperature theta E is conserved during both dry and moist process, or it is conserved both during dry and saturated adiabatic processes. So, I come again, the potential temperature theta is conserved during dry adiabatic processes. The potential temperature theta is conserved during dry adiabatic processes. The equivalent potential temperature theta E is conserved during both dry and saturated adiabatic processes. The equivalent potential temperature theta E is conserved during both dry and saturated adiabatic processes. The last one is the wet bulb potential temperature. Please take down, if a line of constant theta, if the line of constant theta E that passes through TW, if a line of constant theta E that passes through TW of an air parcel is traced back, if line of constant theta E that passes through the TW, that is a wet bulb temperature, is traced back on this QT ln P chart, it intersects the 1000 millibar isobar. The temperature at this point of intersection, the temperature at this point of intersection is the wet bulb potential temperature theta W. Please note equivalent potential temperature and wet bulb potential temperature both correspond to 1000 millibar, but the processes are different. For the equivalent potential temperature, you go through a dry adiabat. Here it will go through a saturated adiabat. Okay, now everything looks very confusing. Once we solve a problem, things will become clear. Now it's high time we stop the discussion and solve a problem involving all these quantities. Let it take half an hour, doesn't matter. I'll dictate the problem, then work on your chart. Okay. So now we are going to solve a problem which involves condensation and release of water and all that. Problem number 37. Please take down. A parcel of air with an initial temperature of 25 degrees Celsius. A parcel of air with an initial temperature of 25 degrees Celsius and a dew point of 10 degrees centigrade. A parcel of air with an initial temperature of 25 degrees Celsius and a dew point of 10 degrees centigrade is lifted adiabatically from the 1000 HPa level. Is lifted adiabatically from the 1000 HPa level, full stop. Determine the LCL and the temperature at that level. If the air parcel is lifted by a further 250 HPa, this is new. You have not done problems like this so far. If the air parcel is lifted by a further 250 HPa above its LCL, what is its final temperature? And how much liquid water is condensed during this rise? How much liquid water is condensed during this rise? Somebody needs a QT lawn P chart? Anybody needs this? Anubhav, do you have this? Give one to Amrita. So let me write down the data. So, which is the moisture parameter which is specified in the problem? TD. Dew point is given, temperature pressure are given, LCL, the temperature at LCL is lifted beyond LCL by 250 HPa. What is the final temperature? How much is the water content? It's a standard problem, take about 15 minutes. Finish? No, it will take about 15 minutes. A standard quiz question. I may complicate it a little further by asking you theta W, theta E, whatever. I may ask you 8 or 9 quantities. Okay. I may also ask you to tie up the QT lawn P chart. along with the answer sheet. Is it okay? So problem 37. What is it, T? 25, yeah? So, is okay? Is okay? Initial point. Dew point is 10. What do you mean by that? Here, huh? Is that the dew point? Hmm. What color do you want? Initial point. Okay, very good. Dew point is over. Next. Oh, this green we'll use for the process. Green color. So from dew point to water you're taking, the so you have to use the not constant D. Constant omega S. Okay. So saturation. So constant saturation mixing ratio is coming like this. That is a dashed line, right? Correct. He also has a mood. What is the value? 8, huh? Class? 6, huh? 7, okay. We will take arithmetic mean. All right. Next. From here, dry adiabat. I will change the color now. Blue, red. So, these are the dry adiabats. Okay. Bad, huh? It's okay. All right. 800, huh? Okay. So let's make a big circle around 800, and so okay. So very good. The LCL lifting condensation level is 800. What is the temperature?
7.
How? Okay, yes. So this is 0. Sai Rahul, is it okay? Okay, so let's write that. Nice. Now comes the story, huh? Saturation adiabat. From here, where is he going? Okay. So, P final? 5? What is this? What is quantity? What is the time drawing? Isobar. P final. Is everybody with me? Now, this is LCL. This is TD. How do you escape this? Good. This is T. So, this is T. Now, from LCL, I have to take a saturation adiabat. This one, huh? I don't want magenta now. Okay. Final point, What is the question now? Temperature, you please tell me, what is the temperature? Minus, So, it is becoming cold. Obviously, it is going up. T equal to minus? Yeah, small variations I will allow. So, problem number 37, LCL, 800 HPa. Temperature at LCL 7 degree centigrade, lifted beyond LCL by 250 HPa, final T minus 12 degree centigrade. Only quantity we have to calculate, item number D, question number D, water condensed. So, you told me that, you already told me that omega S for this fellow is 7. Now, this fellow is already saturated. So, is omega is equal to omega S? Is omega is equal to omega S? Who? That fellow already went up to 550. What is his omega S? 2.75. No, I can't see that. Right, okay. This is 2. Is that correct? This is 5. Correct? What are you saying? 3, So, water removed, What is the question? Water condensed. 4 grams per. So this air parcel has condensed. Then the other story is, if it is condensed and it is thrown out and then it is coming back to 1000 HBar, what will happen? If it is coming back with the same this thing, what will happen? That will lead to equivalent potential temperature, equivalent temperature. It is already 850. So we will solve some problems involving theta W, theta E and all that in the next class. So now we know how to use. So now we know how to use all the lines on this. So in fact, for each of this, you can put PV to the power of gamma is equal to constant, omega S, LVS, and you can solve the whole thing using equations. But we started at 8:38 or something, 13 minutes we solved the whole thing without using any equation. Why? Because all the equations are inbuilt into the chart. It is good, right? And we also use all the colors. Okay. Thank you very much.